After yesterday's Let's Talk Surgery, I had quite a few comments of people saying, yes, indeed, my needle is bending. So what exactly is happening? Now, just think of this needle. Here's my little needle, and I'm holding it two-thirds of the way back. So I'm fixing that position, and I'm trying to roll my wrist. So I'm rolling my wrist, so I'm pointing this force vector in that direction, trying to push it through. But what if the tissue is tough, so I have a much larger vector pushing back at me, and I'm trying to fix this point. Actually, in the fixing that point, I'm even putting torque on that. So what happens is, it is as if there's a mass or weight hanging from this, pulling this down while this point is fixed. This force here has been transmitted along this body, and it's pulling this down, and this poor little needle is going to bend and bend and bend. And there you sit with the bent needle. Of course, the closer you are, if you put it in the middle, the closer you are to the spot that you are working. This is a much straighter line than this. This is a lot more curved. This is almost straight, this line. So doing that punching motion, as I mentioned yesterday, is going to get you through the tissue in a very atraumatic way. You're going to let that reverse cutting needle at the tip do its work and just smoothly glide through that tissue, as opposed to trying to tear and you're causing tears as you move. This needle is moving as far as the tissue is concerning. This cutting edge here, it is like a knife with three edges at the front. It's going to cause this ragged edge as you go through. That hole in the tissue is bigger than this. This is a swage needle, so the material comes out there. It's larger than the thickness of this material, and you have these ugly holes that you're causing. And your needle is bending. So that's actually terrible. Hold it closer. So the complaint is, but now I've got no room to maneuver. I'm going to put the needle through, and it doesn't come out the other side. Well, if it doesn't, if you've put the needle through, and it is there, and the needle's not out the tissue yet, just replace it a little bit. Remember, the tissue is here now. As you pushed it through, replace it a little bit, push it in. Now the tissue is there, take a little bit, push it in. The closer you are working to it, the less of a chance you have. There's a lot more tensile strength in that little bit than distributed across a long section of that. So you're not going to cause damage to your needle. Just push it through, push it through, push it through until it comes out the other side. And treat that tissue. In other words, you're treating the tissue with care, and you're treating the needle with care as well. So you're not going to get this damage to the needle. So that was one. That was the one issue. The other one was, of course, just holding this. So imagine that's my laceration that I'm just trying to suture. Remember, try to work towards yourself always. Don't put sutures in going further and further away. And we're trying to put a suture perpendicularly across the laceration. So I've lifted the patient up. The patient's now on the board here. And if I put this straight, look at the angle at which my wrist has to bend while I'm working, especially if you're trying to hold it far away from here, which I don't like doing at all. Now, some instructors might not like this, but I really like to claw my instruments, because the closer it is to my hand, it actually becomes part of my hand. It is my hand that is working, whereas if I work far away from my hand, it is something else that's working. That's besides the point, though. If I put this at an angle like this, now my wrist is straight while I'm trying to work, and that's much more comfortable to do, and I have much more control over what I'm doing if this needle is put in at an angle. So there we go. Put your needle in the middle. This is a much straighter line. That's going to have a lot less chance to bend. And of course, this reverse cutting edge there, there's actually three cutting edges there. That edge cuts, that edge cuts, that edge cuts. And if you're trying to apply a force, you are actually, the skin starts or the tissue starts slipping here. And instead of a nice, neat little hole, which this suture material can go through, is now much bigger because you made this huge rent in it, actually, as you try to tear it through. That's no good at all. So my advice, really, take it closer. And number one and number two, put your needle on at an angle to your instrument.